key to a good product is knowing your audience. So if you're a video maker, stay tuned for this video. I'm going to talk about MaekerSuite. MaekerSuite is a video platform that could help predict your trends, analyze other similar videos, in turn help you make the right decision and bring value to your video. It can also help you write scripts, check your grammar, make translation. So let's get started because it's filled with a lot of features I want to show you. I'll meet you on the dashboard. So now I'm on the main page of MaekerSuite and I'm going to go over the features very quickly with you. As you can see, you could research a topic, get a script written, or you can start from scratch. It also gives you four different solutions, which is SEO research, video analytics, which is very useful to help define your audience, and content planning, along with AI script writing. So now we're on the dashboard. Once you log in, you're going to see four different options. It's very intuitive design. You have research a topic. You can analyze a video, and that's popping in a URL of a video that you like, and it'll give it the insight, which is very useful. And it could also write the script, and you can start from scratch. Below here, you will see you have a tab called projects, and this is my past projects and my exploration in case I want to revisit it. I have generated ideas. You can see that you could have to do, in progress, or done. It keeps you organized, or you could archive this. So let's start with a research topic. I'm interested in comparing tripods because I take panda photos. Compare tripods. Or maybe I'll do compare tripods for YouTube. I'm going to click start exploration, and this will take a few minutes, so it'll come back. Okay, welcome back. So now you will see under exploration, the first tab by default would be project. Here's compare tripod for YouTube, and I can go in and view the report. So now it's generating my report, and that was quite quick. So here's my topic up there, and it says top five video ideas global is searching everything. And you could narrow it down to different topics like camera gear, Samsung. And as you scroll further, you have different options with different titles. Probably select the first one, but let's go down and look at the research overview. So this video was recommended by YouTube for keyword search, 374. And then numbers of channel analyzed across all the videos is 258. And then total views analyzed, 97 million. There's no way we could do this manually, so this is really awesome that it does all this for us. And now you go down, you're going to see the bubble chart. So the bubble chart has two axes, which one is the relevant. So relevant is, like it said, it's if it's relevant to your video, you know, starting from 30 all the way up to 90 being the most relevant. And on this X, you will see the quality score. If you want it really good quality, then it goes here. So you could hover over these bubbles and then it will tell you the relevance score, like 66, the quality score is 25, camera tripod comparison, and down here has really 1 million views, video equipment. So I'm going to probably select this big bubble one. And once I select that, I can see the data for it. So it says like 100 video in this topic and 31 million views across the topic. 45 numbers of channel, the engagement is 8K, which is good, 342. And then you see the quality score is a little low, but the relevance is a little higher. I like that. And videos within this topic, we could select by the performance. Of course, they're going to put the top one is 93. And it tells you the video length. I usually make videos that are probably 10 minutes long. I like to see something that's around this length. So I'm going to choose this one. So I'm going to click on the little eye. So it's going to take me to more data. So it's going to take me to the actual video. And I could look at the data of this video, which will help me with my research. So in here you have the video. And then this is great. It shows you the hashtag that this video is using. And there's a score up here where it's the performance score is 93. So the performance score shows how well a video has performed after adjusting the number of subscribers, the time that the video has been outlined, and the reach of the channel. And then down here would be the sentiment hovering over it. It says it measures positive or negative the content of the videos are. So yellow would be neutral, and then red, there's no negative here, and there's positive. And you look at the watch intensity. I love this. On a lot of videos, you could tell which part people are watching, you know, with it being on top here. Then you could skip the low one, so it saves you a lot of time. So if I want to click here, so it'll be the minute 8:55. So if I scroll down, oh, over here, it tells you all the stats of this video. And it also has a lot of related videos. Related videos is very important to study because a lot of times related videos are what suggests other videos to come to your videos. Most of my view or most of my new subscribers found me through related videos. So it's always important to know what videos is related, and then you try to see what they've done that is good. And this is awesome because it will tell you the description, it'll tell you the gear, how he does his links, and then you can see the hashtag that he used. So I would take this and I would pop that into my keyword hashtag, and then see down here, so it says YouTube tags. So these, how to balance gimbal, then you could pick out what's related. You could also have this handy little tool here where you could just copy to the clipboard, and then the YouTube tags are tags that are created assigned to the video when uploading it. Okay, so going back up. Now let's go to the next section, which is analyzing a video. I have a video here that I would like to analyze. It's creating a realistic AI avatar. So I'm going to copy and paste here. Lately, I've been interested in finding a good clone avatar because I make videos in case sometimes I don't want to be on camera. I want to test out to see what the AI avatar can do. So I want to get insights on this in case I'm interested in this topic. So I click on there and I just simply paste into the text box. And now it's going to generate the insights for me. That was very quick. So this is great. I'm going to go back to my dashboard. So now that we got that done, we're going to go next to getting your script. So you have to tell it a little bit. I'm going to say, okay. So now I'm in new project. I'm going to fill out these field to tell it a little bit. I'm going to say AI, compare AI clone avatar. Project goal, I put lead generation, select that there. I want the tone to be maybe informational, and then the content would be a video. Down here would be YouTube review, and my target audience will be people looking for AI technology. Okay. And then the target length, I will like to have it maybe 7 minutes, and then the language would be, of course, English, US English. And I have also the option, I'll write this myself or generate the outline. So I'm going to click on generate the outline and I'll meet you back. Now it's working its magic. As you can see, here's the initial brief. This is the prompt that I gave it, and it made a very nice outline, very detailed too, with different headers. And if I like this, I'm going to go ahead and write the script. Now we are back, as you can see. We had the outline in the first tab, and from the outline, we created this script, which took less than 5 minutes. And here we have the script. It has all the headers here. And go down, you see the conclusion. It also has my talking points on the right-hand side over here, outline. And then it tells me how many words is used in the script. So I can also edit the script and I could tell the AI what to do next. I can say maybe I gotta hold the mic this way. Add another paragraph about how many people use AI clone avatar. So I'm gonna ask. And then it has over on this side, the popularity, and then I can insert it below. I could regenerate or I could replace it. So I'm gonna insert below. There we go. So insert it on top, actually. And I can see over here, I can do quick where I have different options. With the quick, I could do a grammar check. I could make it shorter, make it longer, turn into a script, continue writing, and I could translate it into different languages. I can say German. And there you go. I could select that as well. And I could also just check one section of it. I don't have to do the whole page. So I can say, make this shorter. And on here, it's working its magic. And I could replace that. That's great. And go back in here and I can do grammar check. And if I don't select any of the text, it would actually check my entire script. So I'm going to do make shorter for the entire script. So as you can see down here, it says it's generating it. And I also have an option to stop. And I'm going to say replace. And voila, there it is. I'm going to save my project here, and there's also a print button. And going back to the home, you could also create your project from scratch as well. And you can see here, you could write, and then you also have the same options. You have your talking points, so the same template. So let's talk about pricing. So Appsumo currently has a deal on this. And you could start off by just paying $29, which I think is an incredible price for all these features in here. And for all the plans, we'll have future updates. As you can see, it will include the video idea generator, performance indicator, all this that you see here, YouTube tag generator, so on and so forth. And for tier one, you could write 15 scripts. The difference between the three tiers look like the numbers of script and numbers of explorations that you could do and description. So if you want to go all in, then I say go for the tier three because looks like you have almost unlimited everything except for the 250 exploration per month, which I feel like is very generous. Whenever I make a decision to buy a product, I look at the roadmap to see what's up next. So what's planned here is Story Maker, support for more languages, and then multi-use access, watch time retention analytics, that's good, improved video titles, and then on here in progress, fact checker, I like that, a smart tag generator, and then it tells you what is currently live now. My final thoughts on MaekerSuite. Knowing your audience is the key to success. You could create a wonderful video and make it beautiful, but if you don't bring value to the users, it's not going to have them return. And MaekerSuite has a whole bunch of tools where it gives you the upper hand where you can see how the other videos are doing that are similar in your niche. You could look at the tag, you could look at their outline, and this in turn will help you make a better product that is relevant to your audience. I'm also happy with the script writing and the translation. It has a lot of amazing features packed in one, and I think to start off with $29, you can't beat that. It's like having hours of research narrowed down and hours of analyzing other videos narrowed down into this one application. So I definitely recommend it. Let me know if you use it and what your thoughts are. And of course, please subscribe and help me grow this channel. Thank you so much for your support, as always.